Nice job, pal.
Thank you, my friend.
I love that song. That's a great song.
I didn't write it, okay, so.
Well, you collaborated on it.
I collaborated by remembering the lyrics. Not tonight, but.
Not tonight, but it works. It works.
Nobody knows anyway, so what's the difference?
You are so busy. You're all over the place.
Yeah.
You just you travel over to Europe all the time. You sell out all the time over there, and you love to travel to begin with.
Yes, I've growing up in Ocean Grove, New Jersey, which is a small town, I never thought I'd get a chance to see all of the places in the world that I've read about, and now I do. But
so you like to travel. You like to
anywhere but here.
Like
right now.
I know you would. You hate mingling, and you're doing it now.
Yes.
Mingling
with you is like mingling with a whole community.
It is, isn't it?
Yes.
I'm a whole big community in one.
No, you lost a lot of weight, didn't you?
I've lost a few pounds. Justin, get ready for this show. Right here. This is tonight's show. Thank you.
You look good.
Thank you. I look good.
I have never seen Big Joe in a suit and tie before.
It has to be back at midnight tonight, so I gotta hurry it. Let me ask you something. You and I have talked a lot about. You've had a lot of great influences. You've got rockabilly influence. You got blues. You got jazz. There's a lot of stuff that you intertwine. Who are some of your favorite artists that are influences that you started with the great music that you guys started back in the 70s?
Well, I got lucky. I grew up listening to Billie Holiday and Big Joe Turner. And Jimmy Rushing with Count Basie Orchestra, because my parents liked that stuff. But we listened to Elmore James and Muddy Waters and Sonny Boy Williamson, and then the Stax Volts thing came with Otis Redding and Motown with all the different people. So we were really influenced by everything we heard on the radio and just wanted to do every type of music known, because we didn't know any better. I mean,
right.
We just wanted to make the music that really felt heartfelt to us.
And it worked.
Not so far, but we're working on it.
We're working on it. Well, you've got a couple of collaborations, but before we go into that, starting out, a lot of people are emulating you in growing up.
No, they're not. Jesus Christ, don't do that.
Well, they did it with they do it with the music.
And they did it with okay.
Not your lifestyle,
oh,
trust me.
God,
Betty Ford couldn't handle most of the people with your lifestyle. I tell you we're on Sunday night, 7 to 8 p.m. in the old Ed Sullivan time slot?
Sunday?
What do you think we're on, like at midnight to 3 a.m. on the Playboy channel? Where the hell do you think this show's going to air? Instead of Disney, we're going to watch Southside Johnny tonight, kids.
Hi, kids!
It's Uncle Johnny! Here's Johnny! You got a new album out with the Poor
Fools. No, I don't have a new album.
Well, it's been out.
Oh,
it's an album that's been out since 1983. That was his last one. You got the Poor Fools came out a year and a half ago, right?
If you say so.
Or 2 years ago.
I don't know. How would I know?
Because you put it out. It's very good.
Thank you.
The Poor Fools is great because it's a collaboration of older songs that you put together that you really nailed, and it all strings together, but they're different venues.
It was a chance to do a lot of different type of material, you know, country and folk and blues and R&B and those kind of things. So, yeah, it was fun. It was a lot of fun to do, and it didn't take very much. I mean, like a week to record.
Wow, but it's a great job.
And well, thank you.
It really is, and you nail it all. And I'm thrilled for you being here tonight. And
I'm thrilled too. You know, I couldn't be more thrilled.
We'll be right back with Southside Johnny. It's all coming out on the Big Joe Henry Variety Show. Don't go away.